I was very fascinated by this because I had never heard of this program before. How did this program get on your radar?
I read about it. It was a coincidence. I was reading on the train this article about pet partnership in prison. And it was the portrait of the therapist's friends who was doing entrusting small animals to inmates, rabbits, birds, chinchillas, mouses. It was very funny. I was intrigued. I was like, what's happening there? What's this odd pairing? So I went there, spent the day. And I was very heartbroken, but I could witness. The presence of those animals were so healing for them, was like acting like a soothing balm. And they were like they were kind of in a safe place to open themselves, to talk, could feel that they had such a sense of accomplishment and confidence by taking care of those animals. They were proud of it. They could really reconnect with themselves to feel that love and empathy after being incarcerated. And it's not a place where you have so much warmth and contact.
Right.
So I decided to write the rabbits, the short film, about this connection between a female inmate and a rabbit. And then I kept digging into the subject and found out about this program in Nevada with wild horses. That is a feature film. I decided to go to this prison to observe, and I spent years going there, writing about it, gathering elements, listening to stories. It really helped me to deepen my characters and my story.
Wow. Two things that struck me very prolifically while I was watching it. That with an animal like a Mustang and with a man who is incarcerated in prison in the therapy scene where they talk to them about how they ended up in that place, what was the impetus that made them snap? And for a wild horse and for a human being, it only takes a few seconds to snap, depending on the situation, right?
Absolutely. So yeah, it was like, for me, like the identification was very strong. The man and the horse was mirroring each other's journey, like, and kind of trying to build trust and respect by a physical dance, you know, it's kind of a body language that speaks, and they were like having this invisible dialogue into like finally connecting. But it could take like a month, and obviously like the horse is a very fearful animal. It's very sensitive, and it can be like spooked by anything,
right?
And the man's violence and anger, same, can be like erupted in seconds. So definitely, like that behavior was so similar in a way that, I mean, a horse is a prey animal, it's not aggressive, but can he fight back? It can be very unpredictable. And I felt that to see those creatures together, trying to connect, trying to communicate, was so powerful because the horse was teaching the man who he was by mirroring, you know, his behavior and teaching him respect and trust.
That really struck a chord with me. And what also struck a chord with me was the scene with Roman and his daughter. The first scene they had together, I wasn't sure that was his daughter. I wasn't quite sure what their relationship was. And then once I realized that was his daughter, I thought, oh my goodness, him being able to have this relationship with this horse has helped him to open up and try to have a relationship with his daughter.
Absolutely. That was like, he's fighting in three arenas. He's fighting with his daughter in one arena, and with the horse in another arena, and with the horse trainer in a third arena.
And
the triangular relationship, obviously, is very important, that the man is kind of like being, what he gets from the horse is going to try to give to his daughter. So it's kind of like a circle of, this is what I learned, this is what I'm trying to give, until he finally realizes that he's able to express forgiveness and asking for forgiveness. And that's like really like the help of the horse and the impact of the animal to transform him emotionally and physically to be able to be a man and eventually a father.
Yes. In the beginning of the film, there's that frenetic music of violins that's playing while the Mustangs are running from the helicopters. And then all of a sudden, there's this beauty and this serene kind of feeling that comes over the animals right before the chilling chaos hits. And that perfectly sets up the film for me. What made you want to start it out that way with showing the horses? And how? Because what that did for me is it showed that with inmates and with animals, that no animal should be caged, whether they're human or, you know what I mean?
Absolutely. Absolutely. No one should be caged. No one. It's really like, I mean, the sense of punishment. What is the impact of imprisonment? What's the impact of punishing someone? If it's not like, I'm really like education rather than incarceration. And obviously to start start with the animal, to start with their journey of being roughly imprisoned and chased. I wanted to have the point of view of the horse shifting to the point of view of the man. So it's like the horse who tells the story of the man in a way, you know, it's like we follow the lead horse and that actually presents the man. So I was very interested to kind of give this perspective first and to kind of like tell, this is the trajectory of the animal that's kind of like there and you're the trajectory of the man.
Well, I appreciate you sharing this story. Like I said at the beginning of our interview, I'd never heard of the Wild Horse Inmate Program, but through you and your artistry, I do now know about it. And I'm so incredibly grateful. Congratulations again on the film premiering at Sundance, for you taking it from a short to a feature film. I'm so excited for you. I will be rooting for you. And yes, thank you so much for this film. It really touched my heart. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
You're very welcome.